Hello. And welcome back to the awesome adventures of Captain Spirit. Our last episode, we went outside, went into the garage, and got the final piece of our costume. We were completely geared up. We had a shooting out fireballs, and it was pretty amazing. We are Captain Spirit. And as we go through, we learn more and more details about this kid's life. Some good, some bad, unfortunately.
I hope Dad doesn't get in trouble because of me.
So there's a letter inside that says Beaver Creek Social Services. Dear Mr. Erickson, this is Dr. Tamara Fallman of Beaver Creek Social Services. As a representative of the county's elementary school districts, we would appreciate if you could arrange to come in with your son, Chris Erickson, for a meeting on Monday afternoon at 2:50 p.m. at our local offices at 2775 Water Street. If you have any questions, please call our office at 555-687-2006. Sincerely, Tamara Fallman, MSW, PCSS. Services, that's really broad. And when we picked it up, he said out loud, "I hope Dad doesn't get in trouble because of me." Have we been doing something, maybe not doing well at school, or that does seem like a kid that could be really distracted by comics and superheroes. Let's just hope. Social services, is this like, or this could be more like child protective services? No, but it does say as a representative of the county's elementary school districts, so it seems like something to do with school. What has he been doing? So that's if we inspect. Or we can also look.
I wonder if Dad will teach me how to drive.
Probably someday, kid. What year was this set in? Like 2016, maybe. This is an old truck with a stick shift. Probably don't have money to buy a new one, but if this one runs well, don't need to. let's use our superpower on the Spiritmobile. See what happens. Power drive. Oh, I love how we get into our little action pose. Okay, so I did my power move and activated the Spiritmobile, which sent me onto Mandroy's planet. So I think it started the... Well, I'm not sure if that's the final mission or not. It seems like the final mission. I don't know if the game ends after you do that, but I don't want to test it. I want to make sure I do everything first, so I just... I reloaded there, and we'll get to that last. I forgot that was our spaceship. So there's also this other part of the garage.
It sucks we don't use this landing bay much. It's so cool.
Yeah, garage, landing bay, main door. I can open it.
This box has been here forever.
Okay. I guess we can't explore that. We're just gonna open it up, say these boxes have been here forever, and then close it back down. Okay. Well, I think in this episode,
maybe the kids who lived here before didn't like it.
Beaver Creek sucks. That's weird. I guess it's where they live, but the kids wouldn't think so.
It's not safe out there. Yeah, Dad. I know.
It doesn't let me go into the street. It's not safe out there, says the dad. Looks like just a pile of junk over here. There is a washing machine under some... Hey, here's a junk pile.
The Maze of Doom. Captain Spirit heard about the secret treasure inside.
Secret treasure inside of the Maze of Doom. Yeah, you know we're going in. We're not afraid. Let's enter the Maze of Doom. Spooky. It's a lot bigger on the inside. Inside of our imagination, that is. There we go. There's some green gash. It's super spooky. Okay, which way do we go? Go right or go left? Let's go left. Super spooky. Another intersection. Left or right? Let's go left again. Another intersection. Let's go left one more time, just to see. Okay, seems like we're going in circles. We should go right this time. Oh god, we're still in the Maze of Doom. Maybe we have to alternate right, then left, then right again. That way we're still moving forward, right? Right, left, right.
I better look at that map again.
Assemble the two parts of the map to find the way. Oh, okay. Maybe it's just time for us to leave then. was in our bedroom, right? I love the sound of snow boots crunching on the snow.
The secret treasure is buried out there in the wild. Now I have to locate the second part of the map.
As well. I bet the bad guys are. Let's go back outside, even though we just took off all of our outdoor clothing. Oh, that was quick this time. Okay. There's Castle Fireness. The fire. It's the Reynolds house.
I'm glad our neighbors look out for us. They treat us like family.
That's nice. They treat us like family, but why do we label their house as the Fireness house with some sort of evil eye? Maybe the eye isn't evil. Maybe the eye was just like more of a watchful eye. They're watching over us. They have a nice big house. Double, two stories. Backyard shed. They have some lot of really nice Christmas decorations up and outside. They do look like a nice family. There's a hole in the fence, but there's no option for me to crawl under. Alright, let's go check out the Flying Fortress.
Behold, the Flying Fortress.
I do behold, that looks awesome. This fortress looks so neat. I always wanted a treehouse when I was a kid. But there wasn't any trees in my area. So that kinda stopped that. Oh, there's lots of stuff up here. Okay. Secret stash. Sky pirate, a doll, no guard. Okay, let's see what's around here. It's an old bowl.
I had to rescue my old cereal bowl after Dad used it for an ashtray. Gross.
Ew, that actually is really gross. Are you not able to go back and wash it? That's actually really gross. Dad probably thought it was some kid's bowl that doesn't use it anymore, but still, there is a Noctarius.
Maybe I should get a. That's Noctarius' son. He looks like his dad.
Noctarius' son. He's not listed as one of the evil villains. There's a doll.
Dad keeps telling me this is a girl's doll. So what? She's the Ice Queen.
Yeah, like Frozen, the Ice Queen. So what? In our imagination.
fortress looks safe since we last talked.
Good job, Sky Pirate. How's he
doing? Sky Pirate, what's the situation since your last report? Did the storm cause any damage?
No, Captain. The magnetic field protected us from any harm. We're lucky to have you. Keep up your good work.
You go, Sky Pirate. Which is basically a teddy bear with an eye patch and a hook and a pirate's hat with a bandolier of 3 Nerf darts on his chest. Man, Sky Pirate is awesome.
I can't let Dad find my secret stash.
Secret
ever.
Stash. Yeah, but his dad doesn't go up here. What could be in his secret stash? Let's open up the secret stash.
Open sesame.
Nice, I have to say the magic words. Secret stash, there is a comic strip.
I love watching Mom draw her comics.
So his mom drew comics. This one is a guy and a girl. The woman says, "What are you cooking me, my sweet Valentine?" The man says, "Your favorite dish." The girl says, "Pizza." Happy Valentine's Day, sweetheart. So pizza was her mom's favorite dish. Pizza and wine.
Maybe I can use this to read the map.
I saw all these symbols on the map, but I had no idea what it meant. Yes, that must be helpful.
Now I can use this to reveal the full map to my next adventure.
Nice. Okay, good. There's some baseball cards.
These are my favorite baseball players. Even if I don't understand the stats. Did say mean things about Dad, but I can't let him see this.
Dear Mr. Erickson, I wanted to let you know that your son Chris got into a small fight with my son Harry Sorber and his friends after school this week. Chris claimed they were saying inappropriate things about you, but Harry is not that kind of child and only knows you through me. As you know, Harry is an honor student.
My worst report card. I'm doing better now.
Report card from Beaver Creek Elementary School midterm. March 22nd, 2015. Math, B minus. Physical education, D. English, C. History, C plus. Elective art, A. So obviously, he likes art. Seems like the kid that's a little different than normal. He likes art, math, show this letter to his dad, and he said that the kid was saying mean things about his dad. To me, this letter reads as a parent who just thinks their child is the best and could never imagine them doing any wrong. Harry is not that kind of child. You through me. A child does not even have to know the father to make fun of them. The child can only be, or that other child can just say, just your dad sucks. Maybe Chris told him that he was a basketball player. And all the other kids are like, why is he shows that Chris really does care about his dad. He cares what people have to say. And this parent is using, my Harry is an honor student and a decorated Boy Scout, so he could never be mean. Yeah, kids can't be mean. The kid shouldn't have said something. Sounds like it could be it. Well, there's the secret stash. We have a sky pirate, so we found all of the good guys. The sky pirate was the last one. A few more bad guys like Mandron. Let's go sit at the lookout spot. His age are a lot more in depth than you think. Then you realize, you think they're just kids and they don't know anything, but they know.
Captain Spirit is here!
Jeez, that scared me. Yeah, yell to the heavens. The Captain Spirit is there. Strike fear in your enemy's heart.
Dad won't fix the swing because it's too dangerous to fix.
I mean, don't you just have to tie two pieces of rope together? Is it too dangerous to fix or too dangerous to use? There's the Snowmancer. He's a windshield wiper.
I can't fight Snowmancer looking like this. No fair.
Yeah, let's rebuild the Snowmancer, and then we can fight him.
Oh, Snowmancer, this is sad. You used to be a good enemy. Look at you now. How are you supposed to train me to fight Mandroid like that? What can we do?
All right, Snowmancer, let's fix you. Your bottle cap eye fell off. One of your arms, which is a car windshield wiper, fell off. Your hair is cigarette butts. Nose of a beer can is back. Popsicle sticks. Alright, Snowmancer. Looking better.
Now the Snowmancer is ready for battle.
Yes. Are you ready to fight the Snowmancer? Let's blow him up. Let's do our cool imagination. Oh, it's high noon.
Now the Snowmancer is ready for battle.
But his eye fell off. Did that count as battling Snowmancer? Wait, hold on. We got sad because his eye just fell off again. We didn't properly blow him up.
If I get caught, the ice giants will turn me into a popsicle.
To rebuild him or something. How do we do that? There's not an option to fight him or rebuild him again.
Now the Snowmancer is ready for battle.
Says that he's ready for battle. The lake demon. That creepy tree does look, well, creepy. Not sure how to fight Snowmancer.
Beer can smell.
Yeah. I know the feeling. All right, recycling is outside. What can we do? Where's the can't knock over. Let's go look back at that. Still has a cell phone to unlock.
Ah, I need a pin code. What is it? time for Captain Spear to put these pieces together.
Okay. Let's... Hold on a second. Let's put these together.
I have to place it right. Treasure map is not secret anymore. It's mine.
Oh, I see. Yeah, there's the maze attempt. So number one, you go left. Number two, you go right. Number three, left. Four, left. Got it. Left, right, left, left. Perfect, perfect. Now we can get the treasure.
Every superhero team needs a supervillain team.
There's a shark at the Snowmancer. Where are we gonna find that shark? Okay, maybe he's protecting the treasure. Left, right, left, left. We are going. Chest. It's some pictures of Mom. The picture of him with his mom. And he's wearing a superhero costume. That's awesome. A joke with his mom's Saturday's homework. Who's the boss? His mom playing video games. And him, his mom and dad on Christmas. They had a really nice life. Chris is crying a little bit. Chris was crying. Streams of tears down his eyes. eyes are a little red.
Mom was so pretty. I miss Mom's smile.
And that was... that was the greatest treasure of them all.
Now the Snowmancer is ready for battle.
I'm gonna have to look this up. Because I don't know. Let's see. Inside of the garage. Let's turn on the light. However, it's inside.
If Dad used a padlock, he wants to keep me out.
It's inside. Oh, there's also some hiking boots.
Dad never threw away Mom's hiking boots. Good.
And all the stuff in here is just...
Dad never smiles like that anymore.
Championship winner 2005. That was the happiest year of Dad's
life. Dad was so popular.
2005 was the happiest year of Dad's life. Is the code 2005. His mom was obviously still there. He was a championship basketball player. Everything was going right. Could they imagine that this is how it would turn out? Probably not. 2000. Let's see inside, we have a binder. Oh. Yeah. This is stuff that the dad wants to hide from Chris. This is stuff that they wants to hide from their son, and as soon as Chris wrote that title, you kind of heard that sound he made, that like he was just processing the information that he saw. just being coddled. But the rest of the article goes. Police are seeking witnesses to a fatal hit and run that occurred on December 16th.
I know Dad spent a lot of money on the funeral. A lot.
Then there's a, an obituary. Emily Erickson. In loving memory of Emily Erickson. Emily Erickson. Happening. And Dad spent a lot of money on the funeral.
Grandma and Grandpa were so nice. I wish we saw them more.
It says, "Dear Charles, thank you for your lovely note and flowers for Kristen's birthday. They always mean more coming from you. We miss you and would love to come see how Chris is growing. Like you, we also still miss Emily every day.
Thanks for storing my explosives, Chief.
And the dad took the firecrackers.
Now I'm ready to rock. Sorry, Dad.
So we stole back the firecrackers. Man, when this dad wakes up, there's gonna be a lot of things different.
To battle with Captain Spirit.
Go, 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 Captain. Charge your superpower. 3, 2, 1. Charging. Yeah.
Yes! So cool.
Snowmancer almost froze the whole city until Captain Spirit melted him.
Snowmancer stood no chance. I'm gonna find these beer cans, play the game on the phone. But we're almost done. But that will be it for this episode. Snowmancer's defeated. We went to the Flying Fortress. We went through the maze of death. And found an awesome, awesome treasure. Awesome treasure. We went into the locker and found fireworks next to some magazine clippings, some news, some story. But we did a lot. The next episode, imagine, will be the last. Beer cans, mustard party, spaceship, and then I guess just see what comes after that. Maybe we'll finally go and get the Christmas tree with the dad. That'll be fun, won't it? Because we still love our dad. We still love him. And our mom. Still love her just as much. I will never forget. Well, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time in Chris's Imagination, the awesome adventure of Captain Spirit.